You're nearly there, Peter.
I got it, Mom.
Thanks, baby.
Another headache?
Just a little one. Stop worrying.
I wish I could help.
I know you do. Some things, Peter, they're not yours to control. I better get that prescription before the pharmacy closes. Stay out of trouble till I get back. Okay?
I'll be a perfect little angel. Like always.
I better hurry back then. I'll be back soon.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Mr. Pinkle.
Here to get that mixtape copied?
Yeah.
Sure is a nice thing to do for your mom. How's she doing anyway?
She's not doing so well.
I'm sorry to hear that, Pete. Well, I'm sure this is going to make her feel a lot better. Music's got some powerful mojo. Both sides? Come back in about an hour, and it'll be ready.
Hey, Petey! You make that mix for your boyfriend?
Oh, shut up, Clarence.
You brain dead kid? I've told everybody a million times I go by my last name, King. Afraid I'm gonna break it again?
You afraid I'm gonna hit you again?
Listen to you. Pretending you got balls. Hey, how's that lip doing? Gimme that. What are you doing here anyway? You don't have money. Everyone in town's talking about it. Your mom can't even pay her medical bills. She's been going door to door asking for help like some pathetic loser.
Come on. Let's not do this, man.
Do what?
We're just talking.
You done yet? Elephant ears? You must get great reception with those things.
Nah, I'm not done. But your mom?
She sure is.
My dad goes drinking with her doctor. Told him everything. Guess she didn't feel like it was important enough to tell you. Oh, check it out. Dead woman walking. What's the point? Drugs ain't gonna help.
Peter? No! You said you wouldn't fight!
Mom!
Oh, God. I'll call an ambulance.
So close, Peter.
What the? How did I get home?
Gamora!
Saw my mom again. She said I'm close. This temple is really messing with my head.
Hello, Gamora. Oh, hey, Gamora!
Come on, Nebula.
What are you doing?
You can do better than that.
Not Nebula. It's me, Peter, who you like a whole lot and definitely do not want to kill. Come on, this isn't fair! I don't have a sword!
Focus, Nebula. You need to be aware of everything around you. Perception's just as important as strength and speed.
None of them are important when I'm stuck here. I want to use what you've taught me somewhere outside of this room.
Be patient, Nebula. You'll get your chance soon enough.
So now I need patience, too? Looks like you've lost your touch.
Hardly.
That was actually a little impressive.
Just a little?
I can't. Gamora, you're hurting me! Father!
Nebula, you have grown so much.
Father.
You may yet be the greatest assassin in the galaxy. Don't you agree, Gamora?
She's come a long way.
What a pleasant surprise. Perhaps being bested by your sister recalled the importance of humility. I have a mission for you. You will go to a Kree outpost on the planet of Phalion. There you will find General Tarval. He has come into possession of something I require, a device. Gamora, you will fetch the device for me. You, Nebula, you will kill the General.
Thank you, Father. I promise you, I will succeed.
I know you will, daughter.
We will not disappoint you, Father.
But you already have, Gamora. Otherwise, you would not be taking Nebula with you. Go and prepare. You will head out immediately. And Gamora, I know you no longer care. But if you fail, your sister will pay for your missteps. Tell Nebula I wish to speak with her.
Is everything all right? What's going on?
Everything is fine. Don't worry about it.
Everything's fine. That's not what it looked like.
Nebula! Come here!
This is it. My chance to prove myself. Or fail miserably.
Don't worry, Nebula. I've got your back.
No. I've got to do this myself. It's what I've been training for. I won't let Father down. Let's just do this. Nebula! Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But Father...
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Father... Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now!
No, that's not how this works. I don't take orders from you.
Then you leave me no choice.
What are you-
I was trying to snap you out of it before you killed me!
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Well, apparently it was! Stop! Stop slapping me! Stop it! Okay, Uncle!
Don't do that again. I don't know what happened. One minute you and I were walking into the temple, and the next
I know.
Wait, were you... Did you see all that? My memory?
Are you okay?
I never wanted to think of that time in my life again. I've really been trying to let Nebula go. But seeing that... She thought I was being selfish. Taking away everything she worked so hard to achieve.
She tried to kill you. There is no excuse for that. Look, if anyone deserves to hold a grudge, it's you.
That's not how Nebula sees it. That last moment, it became everything. All I remembered of her. But there were times we were happy, despite Thanos. Despite everything, we had each other. Maybe I could have done more.
I know you, Gamora. And I know you tried your absolute best to protect her.
Nebula can't see that? Then that's her problem. Not yours.
Is it? Nebula is who she is because of me. That hatred. That coldness. Her inability to trust anyone. She is Thanos' daughter. Who else could she be after I betrayed her? I failed her.
Listen, you are my friend. And I don't make friends with failures, okay?
I don't think that's true.
Look, the point is, no matter what you did in the past, I will always stand by you. You're awesome. I'm proud to call you my friend.
That is so cheesy.
I know. But I think I've made my point. Now come on. Let's figure out why the Forge brought us here before things get even more... weird. Oh, man. My mom loved this song. She played that record non-stop.
Peter, wait. This place, it seems to be using our memories against us.
Yeah, well, if anything goes wrong, you'll be here to protect me, right?
You're not saying anything, and it's super worrying. Gamora, seriously?
Do you recognize this place?
Yeah. This is where my mom... This is where I saw her last.
I don't know what all this means, Peter. But I hope somehow you get your mom back.
Thanks for understanding.
She's your family. Your real family. I know how much she means to you.
Are you?
You have known me for a while now.
Not your mom, right?
Definitely not.
You came for me. After all these...
Ooh, what are these? They're very shiny.
Hey, over here.
Peter Quill.
I came here expecting to find my mom.
I can explain.
Whoa! Thank you. May I borrow that?
Yeah, sure.
What?
I have another one.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It is so wonderful to be free of that tomb. No longer trapped in my own mind. Alone. You are truly the hero the legends foretold. So brave and handsome. Though perhaps not in the classical sense.
What?
Ha!
You must have many questions for me.
Why were you locked in here?
So that you could find me.
Not very helpful.
I have been waiting for you all this time. The moment you touched the forge, I knew you were the Celestial One, that you could free me. So I reached out to you the only way I could, through your memories. Oh no, that is not what I wanted at all. I am so sorry. I truly did not know you'd feel so violated. I'd hoped you would feel glad to see her again.
Though
you are offended.
How could you possibly know how he feels?
I can show you, angry lady. Oh, no. Never mind. May I show you?
Do it again! Come on!
With great pleasure.
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
Sorry. Inside joke. You wouldn't get it.
Oh, boy.
You see, I am an empath. I can read the emotions of others. It is my duty to help the Celestial One decide the fate of the Forge.
That could really come in handy.
Oh, she's gotta meet the rest of the group.
Yeah. Introduce an emotionally charged being to a group who are emotionally sensitive. Who should we try on first?
I got just the one.
What is this? Why are her head tentacles glowing?
The big green tattoo man is filled with sadness.
What? No!
He lacks direction.
I do not lack direction. Only once have I required a map.
Now he is ashamed for his outburst.
Mantis is an empath, Drax. She can sense your emotions.
I do not show emotion!
She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
She thinks I'm someone called the Celestial One. How about that?
Celestial what?
Why is there only one? And could that one also be me?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes.
Well, I, for one, want to hear it. All of it.
Then it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Peter Quill. I have communicated only through my feelings for years. It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago, the Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited. And waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity. And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, champ?
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature. A wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power.
Yeah, I think you got the wrong guy here. I'm just a kid from Earth.
It does not matter where you were born. It only matters what you do. You are the Celestial One, Peter.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial What's-It, then why didn't the stupid forge work?
Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
Well, that sucks.
Who is sucking what?
No, he means that is unfortunate.
It does not have to suck.
What do we gotta do?
The Celestial One must deliver the forge to the sacred shrine. There you can unlock its true power or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone from any time period back to the realm of the living.
You can bring back anyone? Like, anyone at all?
Anyone who ever existed can be brought back, so long as you have the required energy, of course. One life for one life.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Then let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right
now. Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy
it. Not until my family is returned to me.
I am Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
I can't believe I never thought to ask this question until now, and it's terrifying me. Do you even understand, Groot?
Of course I do. I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. It was a one-time thing.
I am Groot.
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here. Kind of heavy on the responsibility, you know? Let me think on it. Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
You have extraordinarily soft hands. Like, wow. Was there moisturizer built into that tomb thingy?
There was not.
Really? Huh. Well, I guess it's because,
Please, stop talking.
Okay. Yep, not talking.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula.
But that...
But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well, I...
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You had no right to have the antenna woman do that to me.
I just wanted to know what was going on. And here.
In my chest.
In your heart.
It is pumping blood.
Blood and feelings, buddy. Blood and feelings.
She told me I was afraid. I do not like to feel afraid. Such feelings bring me great shame. But talking to you, a frequently scared person, has helped.
Yeah. Anytime, Drax. Hey there, Groot. Oh.
Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
But I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
Hey, bud, what's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision.
What are you?
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
And what happens if Hala gets a hold of it, huh? This falls into the wrong hands, the whole galaxy is screwed.
The whole galaxy is already screwed. It's always screwed. You think if we destroy this thing, that'll make a difference? Ah, the only ones you're screwing are your so-called friends.
Rocket.
You know what, Pete? I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
Lila would be ashamed of you right now.
You saw one damn memory of her. You're talking like you knew her? Go to hell, Pete. Only this time, don't come back!
I am Groot!
You can both go to hell!
Well, that's one way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot!
Fine.
Hey, are you okay? The hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while. Ugh, she won't hear it. Not from me.
So don't give up on her. Family is always worth it.
I know, I'm really trying, but I just can't find the right words with her. But maybe if we had more time, I could try talking to her again when she's calmed down.
Well, they say time heals all wounds.
Who's they?
I have no idea.
Maybe I can get her to hang around. Just... maybe not right now. Think she needs some alone time.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey. It's me. Peter Quill. But, yeah, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool. Yeah, this is really... how's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me out at all.
Oh man, you were awesome. And you only had one arm.
Well, yeah. Nice to know someone appreciates my skills. Gamora never could. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me?
Gamora says she still cares about you.
She sure has a funny way of showing it. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
Well, for one, you've got a pretty screwed up definition of family. Two sisters being forced to fight each other and kill people, that doesn't... sound like a family to me.
It was to me. You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass.
Thank you.
Is everything all right? What's going on?
Everything is fine. Don't worry about it.
Everything's fine. That's not what it looked like.
Nebula! Come here!
Nebula, my favorite daughter.
Father.
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise.
It was easy. I barely broke a sweat.
It may have been easy for you, Nebula, but it was not easy. There is something you must know about Gamora. She said she would not disappoint me, but I am not so sure. Every day, she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her.
Keep an eye on her from now on.
Good. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter.
Father, I need Gamora. She's my teacher and my sister.
You underestimate yourself, Nebula. This mission will prove that. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But Father—
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Nebula.
Father.
You don't need Gamora anymore. And neither do I. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself. Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now! I'm not asking here.
No, that's not how this works. I don't take orders from you.
Then you leave me no choice.
What are you—
She showed me your last mission together.
I tried to show him what really happened with Tarval, but you interrupted us.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what was going on.
But you naturally assumed the worst.
What do you expect after everything that's happened?
Hey!
She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own back. Too bad I had such terrible aim.
Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing?
She was just following orders, Gamora. Thanos made her do it.
It's true, Gamora.
I saved your
life! Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing
If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead! Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse, just to make sure you were still alive.
I'm kind of believing her here, Gamora. She hadn't fake killed you. I'm pretty sure Thanos would have been a lot more thorough.
It's possible. I don't know what to believe.
I'm just trying to keep us together. You're my family. Oh, so you finally agree with me about something.
Guys, stop. You both want the same thing.
He's actually right.
It happens sometimes.
More than sometimes. Thank you.
Maybe we could give each other a chance.
All right.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay. Let's go. Well, it isn't my favorite assassin sisters.
Wow, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter. Give me 1 second. I'll meet you in my room.
Sure. Quill.
Thank you for talking to Nebula. It means a lot to have her here. It gives me hope.
What are you... Ow! Hey!
What?
I don't know, is that a dagger? Is it... What, you got a throwing star there? Whatever, you got something pokey on your hip.
I do not usually hug. You're a good friend, Peter.
Hey, Pete. I threw some mean words your way back there, and I wanted to apologize, you know.
Hey, don't even worry about it, man.
Best friends forever?
Yeah, at least until death.
It's close enough.
Wow, you take great pride in yourself. For someone who is so sad, you are a very nostalgic person.
Hey, whoa, what's the matter? Why are you crying? Why am I crying? Oh, God.
The little box. It brings you so much sorrow.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm cool. Okay.
Everyone on this ship is so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past.
But if we use the Forge, there are a few things about our past we can change.
That does not necessarily mean you should. You must have realized this by now, but if you bring someone back, it can never be as it was. Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time. I loved it.
Hey, Mantis. Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course. But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no distraction.
I didn't know it would do that.
Oh, you have made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
Shambhala.
Tell me
how. How does your light shine in the halls of Shambhala?
The entrance to the shrine. It.
Yay! Another temple!
The Kree were not only skilled warriors. You can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, they like pretty things. We get it. Now what, Pete?
Mantis? Any pointers?
It appears the forge goes there, on the altar.
Seriously? Well, that was anticlimactic.
Much better.
It's not working.
Relic in place. Check. Must be something else to it. Hey guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off. Anything?
I mean, ain't they ever heard of an on switch?
The forge led me here, but has grown quiet.
How do you know I'll make the right choice about the forge?
I do not know that.
Oh.
You are the wielder of the Eternity Forge. It chose you. You must trust there's a reason.
Yeah, okay. No pressure at all. So, what now?
Repair the statues. Determine the fate of the universe.
Oh, is that all?
No. You were saying?
Hey, Rocket. Tell Groot I need some help with the lens thingy.
Okay.
I am Groot.
Yeah, good job, buddy. That forge is gonna be resurrected in no time.
I am Groot.
He says you might destroy it. That he hopes you do.
Is that really what he said? One more to go. Something tells me it's not gonna be easy. Okay, let's see. This big guy used to stand here, holding up that giant whatever it is thingy. Then things go bad. H sets in.
Oh no, I dropped it! Ah!
So where did it go?
goes.
Hey!
It is a hologram. You are so stupid.
Shut up. I knew that.
What now, Celestial One?
Stupid jet boots overheated.
Drax, I need your muscles.
You cannot have them. They are attached to me.
No, I know they... I need your help. I've got to lift something very heavy.
Ah, I see. You are weak. I will help you. I am ready.
Reach! Hey, Rocket! I need you to grab that lens.
Getting crushed to death ain't on my list of to-dos, Pete.
We'll never be able to use the Forge if we don't get that lens.
Right, on it. When I get smushed, I better be first in line for some resurrection! Thanks.
Interesting.
Stop.
But there is still no statue upon which to set it.
I would have gotten the lens, guys. I was just, you know, working up to it.
I got this.
Oh, dang it. That's right.
Maybe I don't got this. Okay, listen up. I need everyone over here.
Nope, not gonna happen.
Just a little higher!
My arms can't go any higher!
Your muscles are soft.
Shut up.
Guys, stop talking-
Like a baby's bottom.
Shut up.
No! That's my face!
A very fat baby.
Sorry. Hey, what do I know about whatever you are, anatomy?
Idiots.
Drop this thing!
No.
These freaking temples. I'm gonna take dynamite to all of them.
Now it is truly time to decide. Turn the Forge to the left to destroy it forever. Turn the Forge to the right to empower it and bring it to its full potential.
Okay.
Wait, his right or your right?
Oh. I don't know.
What?
Let me see.
Wow. I can't believe that almost happened.
Turn it this way to destroy it. Turn it this...
Yeah, we got it. Turn it to the right, Pete.
I'm sorry. But if the Forge can bring back the people we love, it's worth any risk.
As you wish, Celestial One.
We are no better than Thanos.
Don't bring your daddy issues into this.
Watch it, vermin!
Do not threaten my friend.
Pete did the right thing.
Says the raccoon who has no moral compass whatsoever.
Don't call me a raccoon! I'm looking out for Lila!
Process has begun. She's dead, and you can release it.
After.
after you murder someone to bring her back.
Oh, you're gonna give me crap about murdering someone? You worried I'll take your place as the galaxy's number one murderer?
Rocket!
I am Groot! It is over. We won.
No, we just lost. How can neither of you see that?
Guys, we got company!
Thank you, Peter Quill. I never could have found this shrine without you. And the tracking device Jinsar placed on your ship.
You know, I didn't think you could get more annoying than that time you killed me. You really suck.
Their usefulness has expired. Dispose of them.
Not again! God, I have friggin' hate that thing. Oh, I've had about enough of this.
God, boots are more busted than I thought.
How you like me now, huh? Huh?
No!
Perish to the depths, blue demon.
He knows he can just let go, right?
Stop the rodent!
Big blue lady. Not the first time. Intriguing. Can you let me have a minute? Sheesh. Now. Where was I? Well, that was surprisingly easy. Hang on, buddy, I gotcha! Ah, crap!
I am Groot!
It's not like I did it on purpose! He's got a bit of a learning curve!
I am sorry to have made you sad.
We should do this more often. Looks like the boys could use some help.
This won't be easy.
Hope not.
Ah!
Eternity Forge is mine. Baldi, my son, come back to me.
So now Mantis is tagging along, but she's only creating more questions than answers. About the Eternity Forge, about Hala, about everything.
Janitors of the Galaxy, that's what we should be called. And Hala and the Kree, well, they're just the latest cosmic spill.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
Peter handed Hala everything that she wanted.
Well, it seemed like a good idea. It did.
It's what happened next that he should regret.